Hey, Drugs, how you doing? Kel here again. Well, a question I get a lot these days, both in email messages to me and also in the comments section, is how to store tobacco, how to store pipe tobacco. And I just thought I'd go over that real quick, just to show what I'm doing. Everyone has their own way. You know, if it's in tins like this, I just leave it closed so I'm going to start using it, you know. But, you know, I mean, I've got a few of these sitting around the house. I just leave them closed. They're hermetically sealed. They're airtight. But once you open them, you even a little bit to look inside, that's out. Because the tobacco will dry out. You know, once it's opened, you got something else with it. A lot of guys, and I used to do a lot of this in the old days, will store their tobacco in plastic baggies. I did a lot of that for a long time. And I started doing that really when I first started smoking the pipe. Because I never had a lot of tobacco around. I basically stuck to one or two flavors of tobacco from my local. One was called Hellgate Gold. There was a couple of them. Meaning I spoke Hellgate Gold, actually. I like that. Which was it doesn't matter. Anyway, I'm getting off track. But I used to just put my tobacco in baggies, but I'd smoke it, quickly enough that, it'd be gone before, it dried out, and that wasn't a problem. And then I'd just go buy more. But once I started buying more and more tobacco all the time in bigger quantities, this didn't really work out too well. And I really don't recommend you do store your tobacco this way. This is just mainly a bunch of old bags and things I've got in here. Because no matter what you do, even if you double wrap and triple wrap, your bags, they're just going to dry out on you. And it's just, you have to rehydrate your tobacco. It's a pain in the butt. Nothing wrong with rehydrating, but it's better to have it, fresh from the factory, so to speak, the way it is, and not have to rehydrate. One little experiment I've done the last year or so is a friend of mine gave me this big jug, and it's a bale jar, as you can see, with the wire, closure on it with a rubber seal, and I just put baggies inside there, baggies upon baggies, just stuffed in there like this. And a lot of this stuff I smoke on a regular basis, so, I just want to, grab some, some tobacco. I just grab it and go. Some I don't smoke all this on a regular basis, but anyway, this has worked quite well for me. If you have access to a big jar that's going to absolutely seal, absolutely airtight, this works really well. Just to throw your bags in there, and the bags are going to leak a little bit of moisture, of course, but it just goes back into the bag. It kind of all just, I found what it does is over time, it all just kind of, keeps each other humidified. Look, as big as my big fat Irish head. Haven't said that for a while, have I? Anyway, there's that. But what I do recommend long term for storing tobacco is this. This kind of jar here, this is a little mason jar. Seals airtight, in fact. It's a two-piece lid. You have to pop this off. And it's got a rubber seal on it. This is Luxury Navy Flake by Peter Stokelby. Some nice smelling stuff. I think we'll do that for fun. Look at those flakes. Anyway. I just put the tobacco in there, and this will store indefinitely. A lot of guys also quote cellar their tobacco and things like this. And just put it in a cool, dark place, a place, the temperature's not too hot, too cold, around 68 degrees, 70 degrees, whatever I suppose. Not too hot. And in some places dark, you don't want to store your tobacco in the sun, because the sun, I guess, can bleach it out and do weird things to it. Just store it in a cool, dry place, and you can store tobacco like this for long periods of time. Now, I buy these. I just bought two more cases of them, as a matter of fact. I bought these from Walmart. This is a 12-pack of Kerr 1-pint jars. Can you see that? 1-pint jars, canning jars. Okay, and I've got several cases of these right now at this point. Just like I just bought a couple more of them. You there. You there writing and typing that I shouldn't go to Walmart, that Walmart sucks, stop that. I'll just delete your comment. I love Walmart. And you there too. Same comment. No, no, no. Anyway, so that's about it. Use the canning jars. And you can use big canning jars. I recently bought some peaches from Walmart, and they came in what was basically a big canning jar with rubber seal that seals really airtight. When I'm done with those, I wash them out really good and take the labels off, and I use those. They're much larger. And you can get bigger canning jars, too. If you buy lots of bulk tobacco, you can get big canning jars. Also, you can buy bale jars. Oh, where'd it go? It's here somewhere. You can buy big glass bale jars from Walmart, which work good, too. So anyway, that's what I would do, because I've got several stacks of these. I just stack these. I've got, you know, like three sitting here right now. I just stack these boxes one on top of the other, you know, and I organize them usually by English or by aromatic or by vapors is what I do. I mean, I've got one over here, the box over here, what's good over here. Well, here's my aromatic box, you know. Got some RLP6 there. There's another box over here. Here's some Peter Stokkeby Luxury Bullseye Flake, which is one of my favorites. Look in there for fun. That's some nice stuff. So that's what I do. I just store my tobacco that way. But don't store it in baggies. It's just going to go bad on you. It's going to dry all out. And you can rehydrate those. It's hard to rehydrate things like flakes. This is looking at Stokkeby's Luxury Bullseye Flake. This stuff's been, well, I'm showing you this, but just bam. This has been rubbed out a little bit. They recommend you rub the Peter Stokkeby's Luxury Bullseye out, but I have rubbed some out. But I actually kind of like just to fold it up and put my pipe too. I think I'm beginning to prefer that. What we got here? Peter Stokkeby's Balkan Supreme. Some Balkan Supreme in there. Like that stuff. Some Maltese Falcon. Maltese Falcon. Yeah, the point is, you know, and the thing about this is you can put them in these, just leave the tobacco, you know, jars in these boxes. The nice thing is, you know, you get in the mood for tobacco, you just walk over and grab your jar, pop it open. You know, it'll stay in here virtually forever. I mean, you know, the jar becomes its own little environment. You know, it doesn't leak moisture. And that's how I do it. It's very simple. And I've got some bigger jars around here somewhere too with a lot more tobacco in them too. But I like these small ones because I can put, like, you know, just you know, up to 4 ounces in here. I've got some here's some Peter Stokkeby's cherry aromatic tobacco. And this is actually 4 ounces, and you can see the 4 ounces will fit in there. You know, you gotta pack it a little bit. And again, you know, once it comes from the factory or the store, you know, properly humidified, you know, it's going to stay humidified. That's interesting stuff. Haven't had much use for that so far yet. Haven't smoked much of this yet. A little bit. Anyway, that's it. You can do this, like I say, again, if you got a big jar like this that seals airtight, they'll be okay in there in little baggies. But avoid this kind of thing. You just have a bunch of dried out tobacco. And when it gets totally super dry, it's not, you can be hydrated, but it's not the best thing to be doing to get totally dried out, I found. So it can be done, but you know. All right, well, that's it, guys. Hope you're having a good time. Hope you're enjoying your life and enjoying your pipes, because that's what it's all about.